2-0 Lynx. Brennan Burke, Butch Goring, Jen Botchville. Let's welcome in the fourth member of our broadcast crew, Julie Stewart-Binks, downstairs. Julie, welcome.
Well, Brendan, you guys were talking about John Cooper's demeanor, and I spoke about it with former NFL head coach Bruce Arians, who won a Super Bowl with the Buccaneers in 2020, the same year Cooper won his first Stanley Cup with the Lightning. He said he loves that John Cooper is always level-headed on the bench. He said he never changes his emotion. He's not yelling at players. He gives them information. He said he's the coolest, calmest coach that I've ever seen. I asked him, does he remind you of anyone in the NFL? And he said, Bill Belichick, but Bill's a little bit more animated.
Well, thank you for that.
Austin Matthews, he's going to have to deliver. He's actually been very good in this series, certainly in game one. Had a couple goals there. Earlier, he spoke with Julie Stewart-Binks.
Austin, other than staying out of the box, what's something else you guys are keying in on for game three?
I mean, I think that was a big part of it.
How do you keep the foot on the gas?
Well, that's a good question. It's something that obviously a lot of teams, when they get up, they have a tendency to sit back.
I know that your son is in the crowd. There was a moment during warm-ups where you guys are bobbing your head together. What was it like to share that moment with him?
Oh, that's good.
So what's the message rest of the game?
Well, listen, this is far from over. This is the playoffs, so, like, nobody's coasting home here.
Now welcome in former Colombian international legend Juan Pablo Angel. And when we look at this list leading the way, Juan Pablo is Marcelo Martins with 8 goals. But for Bolivia, a limited chance to make the World Cup as it stands right now. Where does his motivation come from?
I mean, Julie, he is having a phenomenal tournament, and you cannot take anything away from him.
We saw his move to PSG. We saw Argentina win Copa America. It feels like there's a bit of a different energy with Lionel Messi. And, Kaylin, what would you say would be Messi's evolution at this point with Argentina?
Rangers went back to the formula that's worked for them, winning the special teams battle and limiting chances against. Ryan Strome returned from injury and showed his effectiveness on the power play. Chris Kreider continued to flourish his record-breaking year on the man advantage. And the new guy, Justin Braun, potted his first goal as a Ranger, proving he can play on the elusive left side. Bottom line, they win and they right the ship before a gigantic matchup with Pittsburgh on Thursday that will go a long way to deciding home ice in the postseason.
With Josh Williams, who told me if he wasn't on this field playing for the Columbus Crew tonight, he would be up in these stands showing support for the team and for the city. He said, I have been an Ohio kid forever.
We now welcome in our CBS Sports golf analyst, Mark Immelman.
He's 0-4 in elimination games. The Bucks are on a 3-game losing streak for the first time all season. What adjustments did he say he needs to make?
Clint, congratulations. We see you really enjoying this moment with your family, with the fans. I know you weren't able to be a part of it last season. What does it mean to experience this now?
Oh, it's great. I mean, it's great for the city.
Now, Mark, all eyes on Tiger Woods on the second nine. We have to ask. It's video that's gone viral at this point, but what happened with the security guard tackling Tiger Woods on 14?
Well, yeah, that was kind of nuts, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, that's what they pride themselves on. And we saw, you know, Rapinoe going out, but Kristen Press, who would be a starter on literally any other team in the World Cup, comes in and almost tactically benefited them because she's so quick. She has such a great work rate. She came in, and there were concerns about one of England's outside backs, Lucy Bronze. Well, there was no problem. You know, in the 10th minute, she's able to connect on that header. And she did dedicate it to her mother, who tragically just passed away for years. But also in this World Cup in particular, the women have had to break societal constructs of how you should act when you celebrate goals, you know, how you should act if you are allowed to be a little bullish as it pertains to social media and quotes and standing up for yourself. And so when I look at this team, I get inspired. I mean, they're so powerful, they're so strong on the pitch, but they are role models for everyone in this world. Down, being on the brink of elimination, match point, coming back, beating Venus Williams, her idol, and then her parents, both former NCAA Division I athletes. They're training her. They're putting her on this path. They said that they're on a 7-year of a 10-year plan to get her to be really a world number one. Wow. That's a lot of pressure, but the fact that she comes from such a good upbringing, you know that they have balance in trying to make her an athlete, but also a good person.
Thank you so much, Max. Now, the biggest difference with the conditions this year is that the field is in much better shape. Last year, it was a quick turnaround after hosting Grey Cup. There was sand and spray paint filling in the holes, but I spoke with the groundskeeper who said there's absolutely no extra sand on the pitch. The conditions are 80% better.
The old adage is you can't win the Masters on Thursday, but you can lose it
And as we just showed, a lot of marquee names lost it on Thursday. Out of the names that we had listed, which poor performance surprised you the most?
Julie, I would have to go with Paul Casey here.
Phil, what a game. All right, disclaimer, I'm obviously from Toronto, okay? But no matter what, this had everything.
I have grown up supporting this club for 10 years. Tonight is all about showing pride for this city. He said, I want people to recognize the players on the field